go, 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 and we're not gonna stop until we get across that goal line. This is a team they say is good. Well, I think we're better than them. They can't lick us. What do you say, man?
Thought that we would be down this year, and to take a group of guys who, I think their attitude about it was that they weren't going to allow us to be down. They were going to do what it took to win ball games. And I go back to the previous year winning a state championship on a Saturday, and then coming back to school on Monday, and going into the weight room Monday morning, and every one of our football players was in there ready to go to work, and they were very enthusiastic, and from my standpoint, I know I talked to some of their coaches that, I think they sent the coaching staff a message. I think those guys said that, basically, that we're not done, and we're going to continue to win ball games, and we're going to start today, and they sent the coaches a message with that, and we knew from that point on that we were going to have ourselves prepared to make sure that these guys have every opportunity for success.
My most memorable moments for the season was probably SHG beating them once again. I mean, everybody talks about it now. It's just a serious game, how we hate each other. I personally have no dislike for SHG, but I think everybody else does in the community.
And they're throwing a pass to
interception.
Ben, you get that touchdown horn ready.
I promise.
And that's Crawford going there, fighting in.
Crawford's fighting. Look at all that Glenwood school.
Pierce and Peters as backfield. And Peters is practicing through there.
Look for a run to the left end.
And
the
handoff. Crawford.
What? Griffin. I had my first interception as a varsity player, and I was playing safety because TJ was injured. And I had a couple pretty good tackles that game, and I feel like overall that's probably one of my best games of the season.
Season was great. A lot of people talk about their senior season being that memorable, and I didn't really think it was until I actually went through a whole senior season. And you know, every game means a lot to you. You go out there and you play every game to win, and you just, every game's something special, and it meant a lot when it was over. And I think we all realized it really seriously hit us when it was over, but when we look back at it a couple weeks later, we had a great season, and through all the weeks that we were winning games, it was great. And you just think back like 4 years ago when we were freshmen, and we went out there and we were 4-5, and then our senior year we go out there and we beat every team that ever beat us. So it was real good. And you know, a couple of the games like,
I'm proud of how we played. Still think we should have done a lot better than we did. The loss was very hard. A lot of seniors were real upset about it, but still overall I think we had a really good season, and I was glad to be a part of the team. I made a lot of friends. We had a lot of fun. It's a blast.
And said, hey, you're not going to be that great this year. You might finish third in conference or whatever.
And we did. We went out there and proved a lot of people wrong, and that's what we had to do for the whole year. Attending games are a lot more exciting in a way because defense to give up 20 points, offense to score 29, or offense to score 29 points, and it come down to like a couple plays in the fourth quarter that would decide the game. But this year, the defense pretty much put the game away in the first half, and it really wasn't much of a question who's going to win the game in the fourth quarter until the last game, maybe.
It's lit and I'm about to go boom. Mercy, mercy, mercy me. My life was a cage, but on stage I'm free. Hyped up, psyched up, ready for wildin'. Standing in a crowd of girls like an island. I see the one I wanna sit, come here cutie. I flip her around and then I work that booty. Work the body, work the body. Slow down girl, you're about to hurt somebody. Hold up yo, let's get just one thing clear. There's only one reason why I came here. Your women don't want me to give it a tip and tell you what's up. Your women don't want me to give it a tip and tell you what's up. Your women don't want me to give it a tip and tell you what's up. I came here tonight to hear the crowd go boom, shake, shake, shake the room. Boom, shake, shake, shake the room. Boom, shake, shake, shake the room. Tick, 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 boom. Well, yo, are y'all ready for me yet?
Pump it up, Prince.
Well, yo, are y'all ready for me yet?
Pump it up, Prince.
Well, yo, are y'all ready for me yet?
Pump it up, Prince.
Well, here I go, here I go, here I go. Yo, dance in the aisles when the Prince steps to it. The rhyme is a football, y'all, and I went and threw it out in the crowd, and yo, it was a good throw. How do I know? Because the crowd went,
ho!
In response to the way that I was kicking it, smooth and individual rhymes, always original, like the Dr. Jekyll man, and this is my hot side. I am the driver, and y'all on a rap ride. So fellas,
yeah,
are y'all with me?
Yeah.
I say fellas,
yeah,
are y'all with me?
Yeah.
Why don't you tell the girls what y'all wanna do? You wanna
ooh.
That's right, yo, and I'm in the flow. So pump up the volume along with the tempo. I want everybody in the house to know I came here tonight to hear the crowd go.
It was pretty scary at first, and then Honkin, Coach Honkin was like, you should relax and do your best, so I just tried my best.
Places and faces and things you ain't never thought about thinking. If you ain't peeped, then you must be drinking.
was just a great class to be with because nobody expected us to do what we did. Came out and got a bunch of guys that would do anything for each other and stuck together all season.
Anytime that you can come out and have a successful season like we did, you have to be pleased with it. You're not always pleased at the end. There's only one team that's not going to end up with a loss at the end, and we've been on that end of it. And of course, it's a lot better, but you can't take anything away from these guys this year because after last year's season, all you heard was how we were losing so much and how, you know, we weren't going to be as talented, we weren't going to be, you know, picked to do this, to win championships and whatever. And I think these guys took it personal, and personal enough that it motivated them. And it was obvious about halfway through the season that to other teams and the people in the community that these guys were for real.
Scored my first touchdown pass in the third conference championship in a row. Just to be able to score in that game was pretty good.
The moment of this season is probably winning the conference championship again, the third year in a row. It was a lot of fun. And second most memorable moment was probably opening kickoff against Jacksonville. I laid this kid out, and it bent my face mask and kind of messed my helmet up because of it.
Fuck.
Crisis, but I can't buy this. Reality bites, but that's what life is.
during the summer with these coaches, and I think they've become kind of like a brother, a father to some of us.
I think we showed a lot of people that picked us not to win as many games or even go to the playoffs. We showed them all that we're not just like a one-year wonder here, and I'm real happy we did that. And with undefeated conference season, that was real nice too, and going 10-0. And then, well, I mean, that was all real good and everything, and I kind of expected us to play real well this year and go to the playoffs and stuff, but if you would have asked me at the beginning of the season if we'd be 9-0 after week 9, I probably would have said probably not, but we always had that chance, we knew.
First things Coach hit on, he said to us, so you guys got a lot of pressure on your back. People just think that you guys are going to fall down on your face, and it was a big thing that affected all of us when we really looked at it, and we all figured, hey, you know, we're going to rise up to this occasion and show people that we can do it, even though, you know, we didn't have Ken Boyle, Chris Ross, Griff Jurgens, all those other guys. They were good. They were great players, but we didn't have them. We did what we did with the players that we had.
As coaches coming off the championship year, we knew that we had a lot of young kids who had practiced against that team all of 1998. And as a result of that, we knew that we had some talent who had provided them with competition and practice throughout the year. We knew also that some things had to happen in the off season. We had to have a good off season. We had to have some kids step up. We talked about it. We thought that we were a playoff team going in, but the kids just took a step farther than what we anticipated they would, and they came out determined, and they came out with a mission, a goal, and they pursued it, you know, with a great deal of intensity. And as a result of that, you know, they ended up being undefeated in the regular season, winning the first playoff game.
Set the boogie, set up, jump the boogie. chicks with beavers, the Northern Lights and the Southern Comfort. And it don't even matter if your veins are punctured. All the crackheads, the critics, the cynics, and all my heroes at the methadone clinic. All you bastards at the IRS, for the crooked cops and the cluttered desks, for the shots of Jack and the caps of meth, half pints of love and the fists of stress, for the hookers all drinking out in Hollywood, and for my hoods of the world misunderstood. I said it's all good and it's all in fun. They get in the pit and try to love someone.
Defensively was just the whole season was a big highlight for me. I didn't play defense last year besides two games when there was people hurt, but I played it in the past and we came in this year and we all just played together and I think our defense really accomplished a lot this year. We really didn't give in to anybody and I think we helped win a lot of games when our offense would struggle at times, but I think our defense stepped it up and kind of set the tone for the games.
Game would be the Carmine White game because I was a little more involved in it passing wise. We didn't run the ball a lot. Well, we ran the ball, but we passed on third and long plays and completed on a few. Our receivers ran good routes and we just clicked passing wise.
Looked at us as like unbeatable, And I guess that kind of just brought me down to, like, back into the world, I guess. And afterwards, we got to say a team prayer, and that was just awesome. I think even though we lost, we became a lot closer as a team. Just everybody in the locker room was struggling with the loss, but we said a prayer afterwards, and that just kind of brought everybody together, and that was definitely awesome.
Tough one. Anybody knows that, you know, when you win 24 ball games in a row, that first loss is going to be a real, real tough loss. And, you know, it was pretty emotional for me, and I know it was emotional for our kids. But when you play a football team who executes like they did, anything can happen. And, you know, I thought that our young men came out and did an outstanding job of keeping us in the game, giving us an opportunity to just keep fighting, because it was always a one-play game. You know, when we took the lead at 8-7, that became pretty big. We held on to that for quite a while. Peoria got a minor drive going. We got them into a third and long situation. Just caught me in a position where I thought, you know, I wanted to give him a different look, and we gave him a different look, and kid cut back into an area that we had vacated with a blitz. We were expecting that they might run some kind of a counter or boot action to the offensive left, our defensive right. It just didn't pan out that way. But, you know, we still had opportunities to win it after that. And you know, I'm still proud of our kids because they played a great game. We only gave up 13 points in that ball game, and you know, we gave up 46 points all year long. So they played tough. They played with a lot of heart, and I was really wanted to keep the run going. But you know, it's all good things come to an end.
Probably my most memorable moment was at practice. It wasn't in a game. It was the week of Peoria, and we were all over there doing offense, and we had just got done with drills, and we looked over, and JD was standing by the fence. We didn't know what was going on, and he yelled at Tim, and Tim started laughing at him, and he just kept on walking, and then he started yelling at him some more, and then everybody turns over, and JD was stuck on the fence, and he couldn't get off.
Well, at a practice one day, I was watching the defensive off and the offense during the offensive group, and I was sitting there talking to a couple people, and I was leaning up against the fence, and I had my pads on, and everybody was getting in, you know, they called off, they were going to go Team O, so I picked my helmet up, and I went to get off, and I was stuck on the fence, and
It wasn't in a game, but that was probably the funniest thing that happened our senior year is when he got stuck on that fence.
As seniors, we really felt like we were going to have a good season. I know last year, looking, you know, with the great football team that we had and winning a state championship, we talked about what we felt like was going to happen when that group of seniors left, and we wondered. Through that season last year, we wondered how good we would be the next year. And after we won the state championship ball game in 1998, we won the ball game on a Saturday. On Monday, we came back to school, and in our early bird program, we got a pretty good idea of how good we were going to be when I know Coach Len Onken and myself walked into the weight room, and every one of our kids was there. Every one of those juniors was in there. They're all ready to go. They're all excited. You know, and it just kind of set the tone for the coaches. I felt like our seniors set the tone for us in that day. They let us know that they had just won a state championship, and they're willing to do the work to go back and do what it took to possibly get another one. I just can't say enough about the work these seniors did. They're a great group. You know, all the pressure that was placed on them coming into their senior year with just coming off a state championship and everybody talking about everyone we had graduated, then these guys go out and win
a third consecutive conference title, make the playoffs, and run into a winning streak that ends up at 24. You just can't say enough about them, and I don't know. I'm extremely proud of them, and won't forget what they've done, and I know these guys will take that with them when they leave Glenwood High School. What they did to carry on, and in the midst of again a lot of question marks and a lot of people saying that the Glenwood High School football, you know, it was just a shot in the pan, and it wasn't going to be the same. These guys came out and through 10 weeks. Demonstrated, you know, just an unbelievable work ethic and ability to come back when things weren't looking good, and you know, to go 10-1 just says a lot about them, and it doesn't say everything about them, but it does say an awful lot about them, and I'll never forget what they did for Glenwood High School, and for me, I'll just never forget having worked with them for the time that I have, and enjoyed it very much, and I wish all those guys all the luck in the world. Woo!